This is Biotecnika, and you're listening to India's first life science podcast, The Voice of Biotecnika.
Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to our weekly podcast channel. Today, I, Urmi Mala, talk about the CRISPR baby scandal. It all started when a Chinese researcher claimed that he had used the gene editing technique CRISPR-Cas9 to modify human embryos in order to make them HIV resistant, and after implanting them into a woman, have made the first CRISPR-edited babies, twin girls named Lulu and Nana. Those two became the first human beings born with genetic modifications that were directed by human beings. It provoked an international outcry. It is like a bombshell revelation. And it just gets worse by the day. It seems that there were a lot of technical errors and ethical blunders in this alleged creation of the world's first gene-edited infants. You may have heard about him in my other podcast on CRISPR's potential uses, where I had mentioned him to be using the CRISPR-Cas9 system to modify the genes of twin girls so that they are born with a deletion in the CCR5 gene, thus conferring resistance to HIV infection. Yes, I'm talking about Hei Jian Kui. He became the center of a global firestorm on November 25, 2018, when he made this fact known to the world. Although he has been sharply criticized for flouting international recommendations and going against ethical rules, it is notable that he did not keep his gene editing ambitions entirely secret. In fact, the young researcher had widely telegraphed his plans and even shared aspects of his plans among senior American scientists and ethicists, hoping to win their endorsement and even seeking advice and help with the publications. Dr. Hei had explained the experiment behind it in an international gene editing summit in Hong Kong. In fact, he also revealed that yet another early pregnancy is underway. Although it is still unclear if his claims are actually correct, as there is no definite evidence if he was actually successful in modifying the girl's genes, yet he was flooded with a swift series of strong reactions and negative comments. CRISPR pioneer Jennifer Doudna was actually horrified on hearing this. And according to NIH director Francis Collins, this experiment was profoundly disturbing. Even Julian Savalesu, an ethicist who feels that gene editing research is a moral responsibility, had described Dr. Hei's work to be monstrous. Dr. Kiran Musunuru from University of Pennsylvania, an expert who has no role in the experiment, considers it to be totally unethical. He feels that we still have a lot of work to do to prove and establish that the procedure is actually safe. He said that no baby should be born at this point of time following the use of this technology, and that this is too early and too immature. He and many mainstream scientists say that this type of gene editing should not be attempted yet because it could make permanent changes to DNA that could affect future generations or even be harmful if other genes are affected. It is extremely important to balance the potential benefits with the potential risks for the people involved. In cases where the potential risks are substantially higher than the benefits, which is in the case of Dr. Hei's incident, is not ethical at all. Hei's choice to alter the particular CCR5 gene has also been criticized by many scientists, partly because of the other ways available to stop people from contracting HIV, like using cesarean sections to deliver the babies of mothers with the virus. Critics feel that other diseases like Huntington's disease or Tay-Sachs disease would be more obvious targets for elimination through editing embryonic genomes. Dr. Hei was aiming at mimicking a mutation existing in about 10% of Europeans, which helps them protect from HIV infection. But it may be possible that Hei might have caused mutations in other parts of the genome, which could easily lead to unpredictable health consequences. Also, CCR5 gene is believed to be helping people fight off the effects of various other infections such as West Nile virus. So if the gene is disabled, the twins could actually become vulnerable, although it may take years to identify those health effects. But if they do suffer and a link is found with Hay's experiment, then Hay could easily be sentenced to imprisonment on charges of practicing medicine illegally, says Jiang Pen, a criminal law scholar at Beijing UZ University. Gene editing has been attempted to treat serious diseases in people, but those changes are only restricted to that person. It is not allowed in the US and even many other countries to be used on embryos which are intended for pregnancy. Shokrat Mitalipov, a reproductive biologist at the Oregon Health and Science University in Portland, fears that this controversy may affect factors such as funding and regulatory approvals. Mitalipov works on repairing mutated genes in human embryos and hopes to edit out heritable diseases one day with this approach. The US government prohibits federal funding for such experiments. Still, Mitalipov and a few other US researchers have somehow managed to get other grant money for their work. This incident makes Mitalipov cautious, like whether this will cause them to face a backlash. Dr. Hay's experiment leaves an array of many other unanswered questions, like whether the prospective parents were properly informed of the risks, why Hay chose only CCR5 modification when clearly there were other proven methods for HIV prevention, why he chose to do the experiment with couples in which the men have HIV, as it's a known fact that women with HIV have a higher chance of passing the virus on to their children. And what were the potential risks of knocking out CCR5, a gene which is normally present in people and which could have some necessary but still unknown functions? All these points actually outweighed the benefits in this case. Chinese authorities' investigation found that He Jiankui had broken national regulations in his controversial work on gene-edited babies. He was even fired by his university. The decision was announced by the Southern University of Science and Technology in Shenzhen in China's Guangdong province on 21st January 2019. This was followed by an investigation by the provincial health authorities, the Guangdong Health Ministry, which were tasked by the National Health Ministry to examine the Hay affair. They had found that Hay broke the national regulations against usage of gene editing for reproductive purposes. During the recruitment of participants, Dr. Hay had used forged ethics review documents and had swapped blood samples to skirt laws and national regulations which forbids people with HIV from using assisted reproductive technologies. This allegation was reported for the first time in Xinhua article. He is fully blamed for this and is criticized for doing all this in pursuit of fame and fortune, deliberately evading oversight. The Xinhua article states that Hay's gene editing activities were clearly prohibited by the state. Although it doesn't mention any punishable crimes and exactly which specific laws or regulations have been broken. The article also reports that Hay and other implicated in the case are going to be dealt with seriously and that the police might also get involved. The article even confirms many details of the case for the first time, like starting from June 2016. According to it, Dr. Hay had put together a team that from March 2017 started recruiting 8 couples, which consisted of an HIV-positive father and an HIV-negative mother, after which Hay's team had edited the genes of embryos from at least 2 couples. It also reported that one other woman involved in the experiment is currently pregnant with a gene-editing embryo. Keeping in mind the conclusions by Guangdong team, China's Education Ministry have announced that they are going to collaborate with other ministries and other departments in building a better regulatory system for overseeing science that will help in improving the ethical review of scientific projects. Stricter laws could be around the corner. Officials at Stanford University are also inquiring some of the several high-profile scientists whom Dr. Hay had consulted They want to understand what liabilities or risks Stanford may have in connection with the controversial medical experiment. Few other scientists, including the CRISPR pioneer Feng Zhang and stem cell biologist Paul Knopfler, have also called for a temporary moratorium on such embryonic gene editing experiments in the wake of Hayes' bombshell. Now, what Dr. Hayes actually criticized for is not for his attempt of germline editing, but because he had neglected adequate safety testing and did not follow standard procedures in procuring participants. He hadn't even responded to Nature's multiple attempts to contact him. So what's next for human gene editing? Dr. Hay have taken a giant leap into an era in which science could rewrite the gene pool of future generations by engineering mutations into human embryos and by altering the human germline. He has also flouted established norms for safety and human protections along the way. The experiments have attracted so much attention that it could easily alter research in the coming years. Hay's actions could practically stall the responsible development of gene editing babies. There is also a concern about how the future of this field can be affected by the public scrutiny, that is, whether or not researchers will look at altering the germline anymore. Negative focus is of course not good. Yet, some predict that this incident may in fact propel human gene editing forwards. According to Jonathan Kimmelman, who specializes in human trials of gene therapies at McGill University in Montreal, the definitive actions of this scandal can expedite global cooperation on the science and its oversight, which could definitely stimulate meaningful advances in this area. On the other hand, if you see, there is actually nothing wrong in helping human beings. This is evolution happening right before our eyes. The future of the human race is here. Scientists are the celebrities of the future. To be clear, no researcher or scientist ever say that CRISPR is bad for the baby for sure. It is more of a question of whether there's any unknown side effect. But someone has to get this started, right? The sooner the better. So maybe Hay's attempt should be appreciated that he took the risk and got it done. Many brand new technologies come with small unknown risk. But we still have to look at the overall pros and cons. Even now, there are people who still argue that electromagnetic wave is very bad for health. Imagine if those people had the upper hand back then and banned the release of radio technology. There would be no radio, GPS, Wi-Fi, cellular communications, anything. But in the end, it's the society who will decide how to move forward. The more people can afford to have their genes changed, more funds can go into the project. The more acceptive society is towards this program, the more flexible it is for the rich to alter their genes. It's a win-win scenario for both rich and poor. There should be also a government subsidy helping the poor family to have their baby's genes changed. So what do you feel about this? Is it even justified to be called as a scandal after all? Or you completely support the negative reviews raised on Dr. Hay's work? We would love to know your opinions. Do let us know in the comment section. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this was Biotecnika for you. Thank you.